Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and we've got some more MLB The Show 16 information today. They released a franchise mode vlog covering some of the updated things they've done into franchise mode, and obviously this is one of the big meat and potatoes modes of the game, so let's go over what was talked about in this vlog. First of all, they have really added robustly to the stats that are tracked in here. Not only the kinds of stats, including your traditional stats and now advanced stats, but you also have stats going all the way back to the start of these players' careers. So as you see here, highlighted is David Ortiz, and you can go all the way back to his rookie season. Now, when I first heard that, I'm like, well, that's great, but I mean, how important is that? But it is cool because you have sorting features in here now where you can actually look up people's career and season numbers and, you know, really see where they stand, not only from where you took them over in a franchise, but also where they stand in a career standpoint. So if you take a team that's got a bunch of veterans and you're pushing someone towards 3,000 hits or a home run milestone, you can look through all that and track that and see, you know, how they've done over their careers. So also this player morale really has me excited as far as running a franchise mode, because now there's a little more to think about other than just putting a roster together that you like with their overalls and all that. But you have to consider if they're happy on your team, if they're happy with the role they're playing on your team. You know, are they a starter? Are they mad they're not getting to play as much as they want to? It's going to add another layer of depth of what you're doing as a general manager or an owner type. Not only just assemble very good talent, but try to get the personalities and those kind of things in line as well. They've also added a bunch to offering contracts here, which is well-deserved and well-needed in the game. I personally think you can assign them a role to try to make them happier about signing with your team. You can try to convince them to come because you're maybe close to home. That's added in here too, as they are now conscious of their region that they're playing in. Maybe you have a guy who's like kind of a small-time guy growing up, doesn't want to play in New York City. I don't know. Just potentials there. This is a neat new screen here. Once a deal is made, you actually see them in their new uniform there as a nice little wrap-up for transactions. You've got your budget screen here now, which is nice because this breaks down kind of like Madden does, where you can see where your revenue is coming in and also where you're spending the money. And some of these have been in here before, but they added a couple things that are really cool, including the revenue sharing and the competitive balance tax. So if you're a team like the Yankees and you're like, you know, I don't care, I'm just going to spend money, and you're going to be seeing that competitive balance tax if you're going over what the salary cap is. They have a nice new look to the stats here. You see the rotographs or whatever you call that here, where you can kind of get a good look just sifting through the players where they actually stack up with each other. That was a kind of cool scene there with David Ortiz. They didn't talk about it, but it looks like they're highlighting his farewell season. Maybe there's some presentation involved with that. I know they've had some elements of that before, like Derek Jeter and things written into the code, but it looks like it's been taken another step here, maybe with players who are on their last leg, and it is actually into the presentation. So I'm going to let this run again here as we kind of talk about our impressions now. I kind of went over what was covered, but as far as how I'm feeling about this, you know, I was mostly excited coming in for Road to the Show. That is one of my bread and butter modes, but I also do play franchise, and looking at what they've added here and shown off today, I'm actually more excited about franchise mode than I was before seeing this, because I really do like some of the things they've done with contracts. I do like the player morale system. I think that there's going to be more to highlight there, and especially for me being a YouTuber and wanting to do a series where I highlight the franchise going on. It'll give more storylines to talk about, players not being happy to be in town, reasons to maybe want to try to trade them to get people who would like to be on this team, you know, just kind of things like that. And then there's also all the stat tracking that you can do now to really tell people and inform them how, you know, your franchise is going as far as that and how players are doing. So there is just more of what they always do every year. They just keep getting more and more robust with what they offer us and more choices of how to play and what to focus on when you are playing. So it makes this one of the deeper franchise modes, I think, that you're going to see out there in sports games. They also said that they took out some of the randomness of signing free agents in the offseason, where, you know, you think you've given them the best offer and just kind of unexplainably they go another route. I mean, obviously that happens in real life once in a while, and they were trying to capture some of that, but they said it's more straightforward here. If you get this interest bar to turn green, as you see on the screen, which it eventually will for this player, they're now very, very likely to sign with your team. Very infrequently are they going to go another way once you get their interest up that way and you've given them the best offer and all that stuff. So it's nice you can give them a role too. You know, you're going to be a depth player, you're going to be ace of the staff, or you're just going to be in the rotation, or you're going to be in the bullpen. You can kind of let them know your expectations, and you can know yourself as you kind of mold your roster going forward on your franchise and really build those roles. So that's kind of cool. They've cleaned up some things here so you can actually see all the transactions that have gone on in the league, not just on your team, but kind of get a recap easier of all those things. So it looks like sponsorships continue. You see that in the menu interface there. Training and scouting returns, that was also in there. So, you know, they've basically taken what was good of last year and the years previous, and they've added on to that once again. You can really say that for every mode. And I say it every year, and I really mean it. I really enjoy how they don't, like, just rip out features that have been in before. They pretty much leave everything intact, but then they add more options and more layers on top of it and more ways you can customize your experience in the game. And this is just the case again here in franchise mode. I really like all the things that you can track. The people who are really into advanced stats are going to be happy that all those stat categories are now in here. You can go ahead and maybe pick your players by those advanced stats. If you want to be Moneyball guys, you can do it. So as if I needed another reason to be excited for March 29th, here it is. Franchise mode is looking good. What are your thoughts, guys? Are you going to dig deep into your franchise this year? What new features of the mode are you most excited about getting your hands on? What's on the top of your list? What are you excited about? Let me know in the comment section below, and we'll see you when we have more news on the show 16. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!